Today, we are going to learn a new chapter in Social Studies, Lesson 9, The Treeless Grasslands. There are different kinds of natural regions on the earth. Each region is unique in terms of its features like climate, soil, vegetation, wildlife, etc. Regions lying in a similar latitudinal zones have a quite identical features. Grasslands are area where the vegetation is dominated by grasses. Grasslands are present in all continent except Antarctica. Grasslands are generally open, fairly flat regions that are dominated by growth of grasses with few or no trees. On the basis of climate, we can divide grasslands into two major types. Grassland that occur in temperate regions, grasslands that occur in tropical regions. These regions fall between forests and deserts in both the hemisphere. Grasslands are present in the drier interiors of the continent and away from the oceans. Tropical grasslands are located close to the equator. Tropical grasslands are also called the savannas. Tropical grasslands are located in torrid zone. These grasslands have relatively high temperatures throughout the year with seasonal rainfall because of their proximity to the equator. Tropical grasslands are located 7 degree to 20 degree north and south of the equator, that is between Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. Temperate grasslands, on the other hand, are located in the temperate zones between the Tropic of Cancer and the Arctic Circle in the Northern Hemisphere and between the Tropic of Capricorn and the Antarctic Circle in the Southern Hemisphere. We know that temperate zone lies between latitudes 23.5 degree north and 66.5 degree north in the Northern Hemisphere and between latitudes 23.5 degree south and 66.5 degree south in the Southern Hemisphere. The grasslands are known by different names in the different parts of the world. Now let's learn major temperate grassland of the world. It's called prairies in North America, pampas in South America, steppes in Asia, velds in South Africa, downs in Australia. Learning objectives of this video. Students, now you know what are grasslands and you can very easily identify the major temperate grasslands in different continents. A quick recap. Grassland, as the name suggests, in other words, a land made up of grasses. Grasses form the dominant type of plant life in these areas. Grasslands make up almost a quarter of the total Earth's land surface. The type of plants that grow in the grasslands depend on the type of climate and the type of soil. In these areas, the rainfall is too little for forests to grow, but just enough to prevent the land from turning into desert. The prairies are located in the heart of a continent. Therefore, the climate in prairies are hot summers and cold winters. The summers are warm with temperatures of around 20 degrees Celsius. Grassland plants are adapted to hot summer temperatures and drought with their slender leaves that help them retain water and deep root system. Winters are very cold in the prairies. Grasslands turn brown in winter and often have a dusting of snow. Temperatures plummet well below 0 degrees Celsius. In winters, a thick blanket of snow covers this region. For example, temperatures in the grassland areas near Winnipeg in Canada can dip up to minus 20 degrees Celsius. Plants use winter snow as insulation and trapping it among the leaves and stems. It rains moderately in this region, about 52 cm to 70 cm, and is ideal for the growth of grasses. Due to absence of north-south barrier, a local wind Chinook blows here. Rainfall occurs mostly in the summer season. Temperate grasslands receive low to moderate precipitation. When we talk about precipitation, we are talking about water that is falling out of the sky from the cloud. This could be rain, drizzle, snow, sleet, hail, etc. Most of this precipitation is in the form of snow in temperate grasslands. Learning objectives. Students, now you will be able to describe the characteristics and climate of the prairies. Precipitation in this region. Low to moderate precipitation makes temperate grassland a difficult place for tall plants such as woody shrubs and trees to grow. Grasses of this area are adapted to cold temperatures. These grasses have deep, massive root systems that take hold in the soil. This allows the grasses to remain firmly rooted in the ground to reduce erosion and to conserve water. A wide variety of plants grow in these grasslands. Temperate grasslands, vegetation can either be short or tall. In areas that receive little precipitation, grasses remain low to the ground. Taller grasses can be found in warmer areas that receive more rainfall. Some examples of vegetation in temperate grasslands include buffalo grass, cacti, sagebrush, perennial grasses, blue grama grasses, etc. Trees are rare in prairies except along the rivers. Trees such as willows, alder, and poplar grows in areas where you get water. Grass grow quickly during the spring season. The grass is green in summer and turns brown in autumn. Grass changes to hay in autumn. Grass is dominant vegetation, but there are also many wildflowers like prairie rose, gumweed, gumbo primrose, spiderwort, goldenrod, clover, wild indigo, cornflower, sunflower are the some of the common flowers in these regions. Wildflowers tend to thrive in the temperate grasslands. Learning objectives. At the end of this video, now you know the effect of climate on vegetation in prairies, different types of vegetation in prairies. Thank you, students. Have a good day.